small fade. Muting.
Hey guys, sorry about that. This is Skylar. I am completely blind. I am autistic, and I have a chronic heart condition. Today, I'm going to talk about some words that I found in the past, and one I found today or yesterday. That is a French word, or I'm going to be talking about French words in general that I happen to be fond of. Now, I am from the USA. I do not speak French. However, I know some words that are French, and those particular words I happen to like. Using the help of Google Translate, I did teach myself one French sentence, and I'm going to try to say it without murdering it. So everybody who's watching this, if you're French and I pronounce anything wrong, please kindly tell me. Je voudrais un crucifix pour Noël. Je voudrais un crucifix pour Noël. I would like a crucifix for Christmas. I taught myself how to say that sentence with Google Translate in French. And I texted it to all my friends, who, by the way, don't speak French either, but just saying, and told them that I would like a crucifix for Christmas. But today we're going to be talking about French words that I do know and why I like them, I guess. I don't know what they mean. Okay, so the whole French, I guess you'd call it word affair, I guess. Love affair with words, a word affair. Started when I was 17, which would have been 2007, but maybe 2008, I don't know. It was somewhere around 2007, 2008, I was 17 years old, and I was listening to this Looney Tunes tape, okay, and they were taking regular songs that actually exist, and doing parodies, Looney Tunes-ish parodies of these pre-existing songs on this tape. One of them was a parody of the song Where the Boys Are. And this one Looney Tunes character, who I guess is French, I don't know her name, but she called her, I guess, crush? I don't know. A crêpe Suzette. So I was like, well, what's a crêpe Suzette? And so I asked my teacher. Basically, a crepe Suzette, if you're not familiar, is a crepe, which is like a very, 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 very thin pancake, which is immersed in an orange reduction sauce. And then this orange reduction sauce is actually, most of the time, made from orange liqueur. Now, we made crepe Suzette at school, but being that I was at a school, we had to do it without orange liqueur, but most of the time the orange sauce contains orange liqueur. Anyways, so then I fell in love with the word liqueur, L-I-Q-U-E-U-R, which so I've been told is a French word. Now, I've been liking the word liquor, L-I-Q-U-O-R, for quite some time, but when I was 17, I fell in love with the word liqueur, L-I-Q-U-E-U-R. I feel it's kind of serpentine. Serpentine means that it's smooth and it has flow. It's an ear-pleasing word. Anyways, so then, that was kind of, I think, my first, that I can remember, love affair with, or word affair, with French. Well, in 2011, I think, or 2010, 3 years later, I fell in love with the word guillotine, or guillotine, G-U-I-L-L-O-T-I-N-E. For those of you who don't know this word, a guillotine or a guillotine is a device that is made for removing the heads of a human. Now, I'm not very, fond of what that device does. Like, I would never do that to somebody, just saying. I'm not the type of person that would actually do that to someone, no matter how angry they make me. Just kidding. But in real life, seriously, I would never do that to somebody. But I do like the sound of the word guillotine or guillotine, however you want to say it. Guillotine is more of the anglicized pronunciation, but the original pronunciation is in fact guillotine. This is a French word. The next one, actually, well, I went to the etymology dictionary. Etymology is the origin of words, and I found out that that the word glycerin actually comes from French roots. It came from Greek glucose, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, which means sweet. Which that's where we get our also that's where we get our word glucose. So, because glycerin supposedly is a sweet tasting compound. And it was discovered by a French man. I don't really know his name, but you can go look that up. Okay. Well, that's an English word, but it has French origin. Also, the scientific name for the licorice plant, Glycyrrhiza glabra, was discovered by a French man, and that name is French. Then, last year, 2017, August of 2017, I fell in love with the name Cheval, or actually the word Cheval. Cheval. It means horse. Oh, I forgot one. In 2016, I fell in love with the word Cufre. There's a game called Millborns, and in it you play a Cufre, which means you take your safety card. There's only four safety cards per deck. And you put it over the, like if somebody put a flat tire card down on you, and you could put a safety card on top of that card. So that's what a Cufre is in the game Millborns. And there's also words that we get from French that are English, like corpse. It comes from the French corps, which means body. And so I really love those very specific words in French. And like, oh, wait a minute, hold on. I left out one that I discovered actually yesterday. Vraisemblance. 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 Similarity of truth. Likelihood. It's the theory that every act in a play should be believable. Comes from French vrai, vrai, meaning truth, which is what I'm telling you right now, truth. So, I even made a Christian hymn, Viva la Crucifix, Long Live the Crucifix. So if there's anything in this video that you don't believe exists, feel free to look it up. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, and I'm sorry that I didn't do it in exactly chronological order. But yeah, hope that you enjoyed this video, and God bless.